Hey, YouTubers, I got a special treat for you today. Now, I know you've heard of the Whopper Plopper. Well, let me tell you what I did. I went down to Bass Pro Shop yesterday, and I got a bunch of new Whopper Ploppers, a brand new style. I've never seen them before. I've normally used the 130. The 130 is a great big plug, the size of this one right here. Here's a Whopper Plopper, and it's the Chris Lane series. And it's a much bigger one than I have on, that I've tied on. Here's the small little bitty one. They got the little 75. It's just half the size of the original Whopper Plopper. And here's another one. This is the Whopper Plopper 75. It's a real fat body. I've never tried it on. It's a brand new lure. I'm one of my little areas down here in Naples, Florida. I got it on 20-pound line. I'm going around the bank and see if I can catch a big fish. So I'm just going to get in close. Throw the Whopper Plopper right down the shoreline. Hey, let's see what happens. You can run it real slow. It really makes a good sound. See if a big one bites it. Might be a really big fish doing this. Hear it? Boy, I can hear it going. Makes a good sound. Oh. Now, one of the problems that we have casting the shoreline, these bulrushes and cattails, that little thing stick way out. So sometimes I have to, on that point coming up, I have to throw out past them to keep from getting on them, hung on them. See, I'm hung on that one. But I might be able to pull loose of it. Yeah. Again, I didn't throw far enough out. So let me get another one here. Top water, so much fun. The visual action of a big old bass. And here in Florida, you don't know about how big the bass are. You could have a really big bass to bite. This isn't just a little pond full of little bass. I mean, I know we've caught a couple little ones, but there's some big bass in here. You gotta slow it down though. I think that's the key to a lot of topwater fishing, particularly this Whopper Plopper. You know, you hear so much about the Whopper Plopper. There's a rage going on right now. Whopper Plopper fishermen are just going crazy. They do it on all the YouTube channels are full of Whopper Plopper stuff. And this is, again, the brand new Whopper Plopper. I'm going to throw way past those things down there. Watch this. Ooh, son. Come out with your fins up. Ooh, what a spot. Come on, bass. Didn't bite it. Oh, well. Oh, that's really cool. These Whopper Plopper time. Looks like a little bit of clouds are forming behind us. And that's always good. One thing that I tell people about topwater fishing like we're having today is low light is a real big deal for topwater. When it's real bright and sunny, they don't bite it as good. So any kind of cloud cover is really good. Or any time of day, say early in the morning or late in the evening, it's really the best time. There was one hit at it. Wasn't very big. Little one hit it. He thought he was big. He thought he was big. He wasn't very big. I'm after a really big fish. I kind of grew up looking for trophies all my life. And so when I, ooh, look at that. You know what they were? They were tilapia on top of the water. Whole bunch of tilapia. And so when I fish, I'm looking for really big trophies. I grew up in Maryland. And, you know, we didn't have many trophy fish there, but Sports of Field had a deal called the Lunker, some kind of Lunker deal. And if you sent a 6-pound bass, oh gosh, that was a tilapia, I think. If you sent pictures and documentation of any bass over 6 pounds, they gave you a little button. And so we'd run around, this was years ago, we'd run around with our hat, with the little buttons on our hats, showing all the big, nice bass we'd caught. Everybody had buttons. Big fish. Okay. Come on, Bass. Latch hold of this thing. I got one. Okay. A whopper plopper time. Oh, we got off right at the last minute. Decent, halfway decent fish. Come right down that shoreline. Another one got it. Oh, that's a bigger one. Yeah. There's a whole bunch of them here. Oh, son. Hey, lighten it up. His whopper ploppers will lighten it up, son. Yeah, that's a nice one. Whopper plopper time. In the sunlight, too. Hey, that's a fun deal. Can't beat that kind of action. Cast after cast. Cast after top. Oh, boy, that's as good as it gets. Can't beat that. Okay, let's try another one. That's two in a row. Let's see if there's a third one. Two in a row, that was pretty cool though. He's trying to get my lure. That son of a gun. He's trying to get my fish. That's the other thing. I don't want him to get either one of them. I only have one lure. And he can get that pretty quick if I don't watch out. You know, alligators, they aren't trying to bite people. They're just trying to get something to eat. And they'll come after a topwater plug really big time. And particularly, a lot of times you get a big bass on, and you're trying, look at this guy. He's just trying to get that plug. He's just zooming in. He's just trying to get my plug. I don't want him. Get out of here, alligator. They're going things. He's not a trained alligator. He's a completely wild alligator, and I'm not trying to molest him. I'm just trying to, I wish he'd leave, because I'm afraid he's going to get my lure. And if I get a really big bass on, I'm going to have to be awful creative to get that bass away from him, because he's going to grab anything I got. He's going to grab my plug, my fish, whatever I can get. This guy here. I don't want that gator. I don't want that. Get away from me, gator. Come on, gator, get away. You know, he's after something to eat. So, you know, your hands, if you put your hands down in the water, that would be a bad deal. Because he thinks it's a fish or something. Now, the problem with alligators isn't necessarily that that's big enough to eat you or bite you, but it can bite you, and they have a disease on their teeth. It's a Staphylococcus infection. And what has happened over the years, it's gotten so bad they can't even treat it. And a lot of people, not a lot of people, but the main cause of alligator death is the infection from the bite. So even a scratch can be lethal. So if you ever get scratched by an alligator or bitten slightly, go straight to the hospital. It's a Staphylococcus infection. Tell them that it's an alligator deal. Maybe they can treat for that Staphylococcus before it ever gets started. See, the nice thing about this plug here, it's nice and heavy. Oh, and they get in the bag. Where is it? Right in front of us? Oh, he's trying to get the fish. He's trying to get my fish. Ah. He's right underneath the boat. Look at that. He's trying to get to everything. Okay. I'm going to turn around real quick. See if I can't get another cast or two. Okay, boys and girls, we're gonna come down this bank. A big one. Pretty big. That was busted it real good. Yes, sir. Yeah, that's a nice one. That's the kind of sign. That's the kind of fish that it takes. That's the kind of whopper plopper fish I'm talking about. That's a good one, son. I love it. Whopper Plopper. This is the Whopper Plopper 75. It's just working really good. The one's coming after it. It got it. He's got a big one. Nice, nice, nice one. I could see him coming after just before he hit it. I could see him coming after it. That was so cool. That was so cool. It was calm enough water, you could see that thing. Okay, a little bit bigger fish. Yep. Now, here's the whole deal. Is that's calm water and it's shady right there. And there's bigger fish. Also, I saw it as it came out of those bushes. I saw it kind of make a swirl. So having calm water is important, because with calm water you can see it make those swirls. And coming after the plug like it did, I threw right there in the shade of those bushes. And he came after that thing really good. I'll make a couple more casts right down. There's a rock or two down there. This whole thing is a rocky pit thing anyhow, but there's a couple big boulders down on that shoreline. Sometimes you can catch... Oh, there's another one. There's another one. There's another one. There's another one. That's what we're talking about, son. Yeah, now we're talking. Oh, we got off. When the sun comes out like it does, there are a lot of times underneath these lily pads, or they're underneath the willows, or they're by the shore. Oh, that's a big one. There's a big one. There's a big one, son. There's a big one. There's a big one. Now we're talking. Now we're talking. That's what it's all about. That's what it's all about. Big time bass. Big time bass. I knew I'd get a big one sooner or later. Yes, sir. Now we're talking. So that's what we're talking about, son. This plug here did it. This plug here did it. Okay, folks. Ah, now we're talking. Big old nice trophy. Not quite trophy, but pretty much nice trophy. It's trophy to a lot of people. I asked my little granddaughter one time. A trophy to her is this bass right here, because that's as big as she's ever caught, probably. But anyway, that's what we're all talking about. Well, folks, I hope I've shown you a few things about these plugs. I'm going to put this one back. You know, that what came out of today's little deal was these Whopper Ploppers are pretty special plugs. They've been really lighting up the fishing world for a long time now. And I like that little 75, that little fat one with the bigger tail. The little small one, this might be a good smallmouth bait. Probably is. It's long, but see, the little tail is not as big as that other one. And this one has a much better sound. It casts much better. It's fatter. I can watch it go through the air better. This one, for some reason, didn't seem to work. It has a different plopper sound. It just has a blade. It doesn't plop at all. But I guess it's a good plug. But anyway, I got a new favorite lure now. How about it? The Whopper Plopper 75 takes my vote, folks. Thanks for watching my channel. You know, my channel is growing real well, and I'm real proud of it. My son Scott's helping me out a lot. I post twice a week. I post on Wednesday evenings about 6 o'clock and Sunday evenings, say about 6 o'clock. So I hope to see you then, and I'll post a lot of great videos. But hey, my choice for today, Whopper Plopper 75.